Hello, this is Amarjot Singh. I'm talking to you from Edmonton, Alberta, where it is cold today. Today is December 5th, and it's close to about minus 11, minus 12 today in Edmonton. It's very cold. I will be visiting Dubai next month, hopefully, if you have sufficient interest to talk to people who have problems in their cases. Maybe they want to discuss with me their immigration problems, or their maybe a new cases for express entry or entrepreneur. So I'll be there for just about 2 days. So you can come and meet me and bring your file, bring your documentation, and I will be able to give you my opinion. If you value my opinion, then I will give it to you. And the cost always remains the same, which is only $220. $220 will make you enough expert in immigration case that you can do it on your own. So that will be, I posted a link, and I'll post this link one more time. So you need to register. Let me know if you want to come so that I know how many people are expected, and that way we can plan ahead. I posted a video recently today about genuine marriage in spouse visas. How do they determine what is a genuine marriage and what is not genuine, so that they can disallow or disapprove non-genuine marriages. It is an important classification to understand when you are applying for a marriage sponsorship. So make sure you look at that video as well. If you have any question, you can ask me. I got somebody asking me questions here. Let me see who's answering. Mohammed Ahmed is asking me some question. I think saying Sastrikal. Yes, Mohammed Ahmed, go ahead. If you have any question, let me know what your question is, so that if I know the answer, I can I can tell you. There was a guy who was calling me from Dubai somewhere, maybe UAE, and asking about whether they can apply for a refugee case. I think they are from some part of the world where there is a problem. Maybe crime and other political problem. And they were wondering, living in Dubai, can they come to Canada as a refugee? And my short answer is, of course, we have to look at the information in detail, but my short answer is, you have to understand the definition of refugee under United Nations and, of course, in Canada, IRPA. The definition of refugee is very simple. You must be able to prove that you are a refugee under the definition of UNHCR, under one of those six nexus grounds, which is political problem or race, religion, membership in a social class. And there are two more, which I don't remember right now, but there are total minimum of five. I think they are about six. If you can prove that you are a refugee under that definition, and if you have evidence, then you should be able to get the refugee, it's called RST, Refugee Status Determination Certificate from United Nations HCR, and only then you can be accepted into Canada. Whether you do it in Canada or you do it outside Canada, you have to undergo this process, and only then you can come here. So that's my short answer. But people ask me those questions on, some people are preaching, Mama there, but hold on just a minute, all right? So. I will come back to your comments later on. So some people ask me, and this is very funny, and I sometimes wonder how this mentality is. So if you ask me directly that, Mr. Amarjot, how much money will you charge to do this case, and tell me your flat fee, will you charge $1,000 or $2,000 or more or something, and take this money and give me the visa, will you please? And I always tell them, how can I know your case until I speak to you first, until I analyze your case? How can I tell you whether your case will be successful? It is like going to a doctor and saying, doctor, how much money will you charge to treat me for this disease? And the doctor says, we don't even know what your disease is. We need to spend some time to understand your disease, to understand your background, and then to prescribe a set of medicines or set of any alternative therapy which will cure this problem. So we need to spend time on basic diagnosis. In my business, I have to do a basic consultation or assessment to find out whether your problem can be even solved, or maybe you can solve it on your own. And for this, I charge a $220 consultation fees. And people are not ready to pay $220, and they are ready to throw thousands of dollars on some other so-called dream process by which they think that they will get a guaranteed visa. It's not going to happen. And then you will always fall prey to fake consultants and fake processes. All right, so that's what I wanted to say. So let's take a look at some comments that somebody has posted. Muhammad Ahmed has saying, what is Muhammad Ahmed saying? I'm working in Bahrain 10 years, but I'm not educated. Muhammad Ahmed, so if you are working in Bahrain and not educated, so you know, you got to be able to find a job. You have to find a job in Canada, and then you can apply for a work permit. That's all I can say, brother. What is Harpreet saying? Is saying what? I need to know which visa is good for Canada, PR or student visa. I am married and my wife is a dentist and I'm a business management guy. Harpreet, this is it's not very clear whether you are eligible or not. And I cannot do a full consultation on this forum talking to you while other people are listening. So I have to talk to you private one-to-one. You have to check out the points for express entry. If you do qualify, the express entry points are visible on the CIC website. And I've made a number of videos also on my personal playlist on the YouTube so that you can take a look whether you have enough points. If yes, then express entry may be the solution that you and your family is looking for. All right, so that is a possibility. Who else is asking this questions? Rana Sikandar. Rana Sikandar is saying, hello, sir. Hello to Rana Sikandar, wherever you are. So that's what my answer to Harpreet was. Anybody who has good education means anybody who has at least a bachelor's and master's degree plus at least 3 years plus experience, high English means reading, speaking, writing, listening, at least 8 8 8 8 8, you know, and low age, not like 40s and 50s, they can be a good applicant for express entry. So you should be able to apply for express entry. People ask me sometimes, hey, how much minimum English? I mean, can we do it at 6? You know, this is a competition for points. If you are stuck at 6, you are not going to move anywhere on the up. You need to score high marks. You know, I said 8. Sometimes I was surprised. Some people I met, they have even 9. So that's what you should target at. All right. So that's my short answer there. Mandeep Singh, who is Mandeep Singh? And let's check out what he's saying. Hello, sir. My parents have a travel history of UK and Europe, but the travel history is more than 10 years old. Will that travel history help in Canada visitor visa application? This is a nebulous question on, you know, you have a travel history of 10 years old or something, and then you think that may become, if you're using that alone as the basis of Canada TRV, that may not be enough. For travel to Canada, you must have a defined purpose. Where are you going? Why are you going? Who will pay the money? Where will you stay? What is your accomplished objective in going to Canada? What the hell will you do? Where are you heading to? Which city? Where will you go? Who will you meet? And, you know, why will you come back? Do you have a job in your country? Do you have all these things are looked at in about 2 or 3 minute analysis. So travel history alone is not enough to win this game. You have to have a combination of all those factors. So I hope you understand, you know, just because travel history, some people, you know, they ask me, they have a visa for US, they have a visa for Australia, they have a visa for Germany, they have visa for other countries. And they're asking me, can they now get the visa for Canada? I say, you know, come on. I mean, how can you predicate the Canadian visa basis on all these existing visas in the past? But this is in no way guarantor for Canada visa. Canada visa is an independent visa. looked at in a separate independent submission analysis, not based on whether you went to US or not, all right? So it has not much of a linkage. Some linkage, not much, all right? So let me see who else is asking question. A lot of people ask questions, and sometimes I will miss their questions here. Muhammad Washim, okay, hello. Yes, hello, Muhammad Washim. Muhammad Ahmed, light driver, my job right now, I can read English. What do you mean read? I know you can read English. When you say read means R-E-E-D English. I can speak English, also writing little. Oh, wonderful. Guys, first of all, can you hear my voice okay, or do I need to speak up a little volume high? Or just let me know if you can type, is my voice okay? So Muhammad Ahmed is asking me, I can read English, I can speak, writing a little. Muhammad Ahmed, what do you want me to do for you, brother? I mean, I know your English is going up, but what on earth do you want me to do for you? I do not know what your question is. What is the same thing talking? Hello, sir, I'm working as a heavy truck driver, but I want to go to Canada for truck driver. The same thing, all you have to do is find a job, and you are asking the wrong person, because I do not have a job for anybody and I cannot search for a job for anybody. So you have to independently on your own find a trucking employer who likes your experience and they are willing to offer a LMIA for you, and then you can apply for a work visa. Unfortunately, there's a lot of malpractice and corruption in the marketplace, and many people are duping each other based on, you know, whatever LMIA prices they are charging. But I have nothing to do with it, and I will never charge anybody for getting a job. That's why I'm away from this LMIA market business. All right, so that's what you have to do. Let's check out some questions. Who is somebody's asking question? May I miss out? Who is Vishnu AR? Vishnu AR. What I know Vishnu? I think I may have talked to Vishnu AR before. What are the chances of student visa together with the spouse in case I want your support? How to contact you? Vishnu AR, first of all, my contact information, my name, email, Facebook, everything is listed on my profile, on my YouTube. If you forget everything, go ahead and type my name on Google. You will see my email address and everything. I'm always surprised people are asking me, what is your phone number? What is your email address? Even though everything is visible on the profile, it's on the YouTube profile, on the Facebook profile, everything is listed. I'm not hiding anywhere. I'm in Edmonton, Canada. If you type my name, Amarjot Singh, in just Amarjot Singh Immigration, Amarjot Singh Canada, you will see all my contact information. So you can contact from there, number one. Number two, you're asking about what are the chances of student visa together? Yes. Student visa can be applied both together at the same time. Husband, wife can apply, and another person can apply as a dependent. Not a problem. The law does not prohibit anybody to apply together. You can get the visa and the work permit for the other at the same time. And if you want to get my support, yes, we can. You can call me independently, and then we can talk about your case. But I always charge $220, as you must have seen on my profile. If this is the fee that you can afford to pay, I can give you specific advice how to prepare your own case, and then you can go from there. All right. So this is my answer to you, Vishnu AR. So who else is talking here? Let's see, Sartaj Sahota. I'm going one by one, guys, so it just takes me time to go to the comments. Sartaj Sahota is saying, I overstayed in Cyprus with tourist visa. I'm a good player of martial arts. Please tell about strong. Please tell about strong for Canada sports visa. I don't understand your question, Sartaj Sahota. I mean, you are, first of all, you are in Cyprus and you have overstayed. So that's the number one problem, because now the Canadian visa officer is thinking, why will you go to Canada and respect the conditions of the visa? Because you already showed that you cannot respect the conditions of Cyprus. So that's a problem number one. The problem number two is, if you are going on a tourist visa, what on earth are you going there for? Are you going there to play martial arts? Are you going there to visit or shop or something? We don't know. So you need to have a strong purpose of travel and strong itinerary, and so that you can satisfy them, why are you going there? So that's my short answer to you. Mandeep Singh is saying, can you help with visitor visa? Mandeep Singh, I normally don't do the visitor visa application typically for anybody. My job is my job is to do consultation to tell you how you can do it on your own. In addition, I will take also the refused cases. So I can take cases which are refused. I can appeal those cases, but the fresh first-time cases, I want you to do it on your own. There's no point you giving me all the money and I do the case for you, because ultimately your documentation, your facts will speak for it themselves. All right, so that's my short answer. Who else is asking me question? Muhammad Wasim, you have questions regarding work permit? I've made many videos about work permit, so I hope you have seen my videos about work permit. I have explained everything, what the work permit is, what the LMI is, and how to proceed. So based on your case itself, you should be able to decipher some information from there. But hey, if you want to talk specific, then call me separate and then we can go from there. So all right. Harpreet Singh is saying voice is fine. Oh, thank you, Mr. Harpreet, for that consolation. That I was wondering, maybe my voice is too low. I'm not trying to increase the volume. That's wonderful. Thank you very much for your feedback. Rana Sikandar, Rana Sikandar saying Canada work visa, what I'm doing jobless, my job is priority delay. I have no idea what language you're typing, brother Rana Sikandar. You're typing English or French or Spanish? We have no idea. I don't think anybody has. So we don't know what you're typing on what you're saying. Muhammad Wasim is saying, I'm watching your videos. Thank you very much for following. If you're watching, I hope you're getting some benefit out of it. Sartaj Sota, please tell me strong ties to come back home because I overstayed in Cyprus. Right? Sartaj Sota, I don't think you will get the Canada visa because you have overstayed in Cyprus twice. That's I thought it was only once. So I do not know how could you. Did you come back again and overstay twice? That's little, maybe even bad immigration history. So I'm sure the Canada visa officer is looking at this information. They're not going to be very happy about your immigration and travel history, all right? So Mandeep Singh, can you launch Vista visa? Can you help? I can help, but you know, I need to talk to you separately to find out what's going on and what are the chances and what are you doing. So we can talk to you separately, Mandeep Singh. Who else is asking a question? Jaspreet Kaur is asking, my parents refused three times. Where can I see you in BC office? Jaspreet Kaur, first of all, I am not in BC. You can find my location by going to my profile on Facebook or YouTube, or just type my name on Google. You will see my website and my address. So I don't live in BC. I live in Alberta in Edmonton. So that's number one fact. So if you want to come and meet me in person, like face to face, then you need to come fly to Edmonton and meet me. That's number one. If you want to talk to me on phone, you have my phone. You can talk to me on phone or Skype or, you know, WhatsApp video call or whatever. So that way I can be contacted. Number three, if your parents' visa have been refused three times, if you live in BC, Surrey, Vancouver, somewhere, you may want to visit some local immigration lawyers in BC and Surrey, and I'm sure there are hundreds of them in that area. So that might be some helpful to you. But ultimately, if you want to contact me, my contact information is listed on my website. So please, one more time for everybody, if you want to know where I am, go ahead and type my name on Google. You will see my contact information and other information, other videos and other information about me. And I'm really tired on telling everybody time and again that I do not live in India. I do not live in BC. I do not live in Ontario. People will sometimes say, can I meet you today? And say, look, I'm not in Toronto. I'm in Edmonton. So if you want to come in Edmonton, yes, you're welcome. But I am in Edmonton. All right. So that's where I am. So all this information is listed on my profile. So let's see who else is what's his question? Muhammad Wasim, what is the time duration of work permit if I'm applying for UAE? How much time take to verify police clearance and more when the employer will apply? Muhammad Wasim, those are questions which need some more specific information for you to know. Once your work permit is applied, and I think if you are in UAE, Abu Dhabi may have 2 months, 3 months. I do not know what is the processing time. I do not know the processing time of all over the world. Every visa office has a different processing time. So you need to check up with the UAE office. I'm guessing maybe 2 months or 3 months. I'm guessing, that's my guess, but you know, go ahead and check with them. That's number one. Number two, your question was to verify police clearance and moreover. So all that investigation and checking is done by the visa office in UAE, and they will take the time to check anything. I do not know how long will it take. So typically, you can check on the website what is the processing time. It could be 2 months, 3 months. I know in India right now, it is taking close to 4 to 6 months for all this checking and all this inspection. All right, so this is just an estimate, but every visa office in every country is different. All right, so that's need to know. And when the employer, you were asking employer will ask the service candidate for the LMIA, and that will take another 4 to 5 months, sometimes even shorter, depending on what is the credential of the employer. So that's is my answer to your question. Who else is somebody's they are typing this so quickly I cannot follow. Okay, Rana Sikandar is typing in Urdu, and I have no idea what you're typing, Rana Sikandar, because I do not know Urdu. So you have to know English, brother. So I don't read Urdu, I cannot. Harpreet Singh, is that a good idea to come to Canada and study visa, specifically when the hell a lot of people are coming these days? Is there a VR? I don't know what. Harpreet Singh, this is a imaginative question. If all the world is coming to Canada on a student visa, will that apply to you as well? That, you know, that depends on what your situation is. As I said earlier, close to 150,000 students from India are coming to Canada every year. Canada needs qualified students, but are you a right student material? Will it benefit you? Not, you have to assess on your own. You have to self-appraise your own situation to see, is it a good idea for you? Not, for some people, it's a very good idea. For others people, it may not be that good ideas. All right. So that's my short answer. Mohammed Ahmed, can I call you tomorrow, 10:15 India time? I don't know what 10 and 15, you know, right now it's afternoon in Canada, in Edmonton, it's 2:14 p.m. So I don't know what this time right now in India or in Dubai. So India should be around close to 3 in the morning, close to. So that's the time difference here. So you have to plan accordingly. Right now it's 2:15 p.m. in Canada, in Edmonton, where I am. So you have to plan accordingly. So that's Sahuta. Sorry, sir, I'm only one time overstay. In Cyprus, I'm officially recognized by the Indian National Body of Martial Arts now, and the way doing job, and also my martial arts degree. So please get Canada visa official. I'm not in the business of doing an official invitation letter. First of all, I don't have one. So I do not know why you are coming to Canada. You better have a strong reason to go to Canada, because with the history that you have a great chance of being refused. So I really don't know what your background is and why you're coming. If you have enough experience in martial arts, and at least for 2 years in the past 5 years, it is possible that you may qualify for PR directly without coming here on a visitor visa. So that's something you have to look into the rules for the self-employment. But if you are just looking to come here on a visitor visa, I'm not satisfied that why are you coming to visitor visa, to what? I mean, are you coming here for shopping? Are you coming here for playing in the snow? What? Why are you coming here? Unless, you know, you have some family member or something, they're calling you for some celebration, that's something else. So your purpose is not clear to me, and I bet the visa officer will also not be satisfied what your purpose is. So that's a problem. All right, so Mohammed Vashim, I want to apply for workman month of January. Mohammed Vashim, you are asking me all this question when you are not telling me that you applied. So you need to follow up with your visa office or through the lawyer or consultant who filed the case to find out what the delay is, and they will be able to tell you. The funny thing is that people go to a different lawyer to apply for the visa, but they never ask them this question. They come to me to ask those questions. Can you imagine this? You go to doctor number one and say, doctor, give me the medicine, and doctor gives you medicine. And then you go to doctor number two and you say, hey, doctor number two, can you tell me if the doctor number one is good? Because he charged me this, he gave me this medicine, but can you verify that the first medicine was okay or not? And the doctor number two, come on. You paid money to the doctor number one and you are coming for advice to doctor number two. That's what people do. So Mohammed Vaseem may have applied through some consultant or on their own. And now you are asking me, how long will it take for the work permit in Abu Dhabi, which is given my answer. You know, you have to check with the visa office. All right. So who else is Jaspreet Kaur? Thanks for the reply. One more question. So is my friend apply for LMO when our visa expired? Is that a good idea? We don't know whether it's a good idea or not. Yes, if the LMO is expired and if the friend is in Canada, I hope they are not out of status to get the work permit again. And if you have a successful LMO, they have to leave the country at least once. All right. So that's the law. So if you are overstayed in Canada, even if you have a LMIE which is active, you will not be able to get the work permit quite readily. Not in all cases, but quite readily. All right. So Mohammed Vashim, my case update is I have somebody please can what be the next step and apply through one of the consultancy from I do not know through one of the you have to if your work permit application is already in process and if you have a W number, a file number, then you can check online what the delay is and you can contact the Abu Dhabi visa office to find out what is the update. Because if it was submitted in January, means what, about 10 months? 11 months ago, that's a long time. It cannot take that long. It close to 4 to 5 months is normal, but not that long, all right. So thank you very much for your time. Mohammed Vashim is saying, thank you, sir, for your answer. That's all the pretty much all the questions, the short answers I can give you for all your questions. Now, remember, all these questions require most questions require detailed analysis of what is happening specific to your background. It is never so easy to give a yes and no answer to these complex questions. For example, people ask me, whether I'll get the visa or whether I'll not get the visa. I cannot say yes or no. It's not that simple. Each case and each patient, each application has its own pros and cons, and we have to individually appraise it. All right. So what's the question here? Mohammed Ahmed, so Canada time 8:39 p.m. Canada time 8:30 p.m. No, Canada time 8:30 p.m. is too late for me. The better time is till about 6 o'clock evening time in Canada. So right now it's 2:20 p.m. So another four hours, that's it. So after 6:30 or maximum till 7 o'clock, I do not take any calls, because if I start taking calls, I will be taking calls all the evening and until the night, and it's not good. All right, so you better be a little early. I think that might be easier. So thank you very much. Many people who have asked questions, many people have shared and participated in this discussion. I will be in Dubai, first in Dubai and then in New Delhi. And anybody who wants to meet me in Dubai, they need to email me their intent to come and meet me. You can bring your own case file or anything that you want. I can talk to you face to face. I'll meet you in person, and then we'll go for there to find out what is happening in your case. The fee is only $220, but it has to be paid in advance, and then we can meet. So I'm only looking to meet not more than 15 people. So that's the limit. If you are interested, please email me in advance and let me know if you want to meet. So many people who are living in different places like Saudi or Oman or Doha or something, they say, hey, can you come there? And I cannot go anywhere. Dubai is the central place. If you want to meet me, you have to come to Dubai to meet me. Otherwise, there's no need to come. You can talk to me face to face, just like I'm talking here on Skype or on WhatsApp video call. All right. So thank you very much for your time, and I'll talk to you later. So that's all for today, and I hope you will follow my rest of the updates as well.